Graph theory and combinatorics. Course code is CS309, semester 5, module 3. And I am Vinmol Keshadas, assistant professor, Department of Mathematics in Rajagiri School of Engineering and Technology. First is the definition of trees. A tree is a connected graph without any circuits. And a forest is a collection of trees. And a pendant vertex, which is also known as leaf, is a vertex of degree 1. Then a spanning subgraph is a subgraph with a vertex at V of D. A spanning tree is a spanning subgraph that is a tree. So, from the definition, we can say that a tree has to be a simple graph. That is, it should not have a self loop or parallel edges because they both form circuits. So, every component of a forest is a tree. So, we can say paths are also trees. So, a tree is a path if and only if its maximum degree is 2. And you can see the examples given below. These are the examples of trees. And in tree, you can see that that is a root. And also, you are given internal node, leaf node, etc. So, you can see that. Next is some properties of trees. First property is every tree with at least 2 vertices has at least 2 pendant vertices. Then second property is there is only one and only one path between every pair of vertices in a tree T. The proof is since T is a connected graph, there must exist at least one path between every pair of vertices in T. And now suppose that between every 2 vertices A and B of tree T, there are 2 distinct paths. And the union of these 2 paths will again contain a circuit, which implies T cannot be a tree. So we have reached a contradiction. So that means there exists only one path between every pair of vertices in a tree T. Next, conversely also we can say that if there is a path between every pair of vertices, then G is a tree. That's the next theorem. So, the proof is the existence of a path between every pair of vertices assures that G is connected. Then a circuit or a cycle in a graph implies that there is at least one pair of vertices A and B such that there exist 2 distinct paths between A and B for the path to be closed. So, since G has only one and only one path between every pair of vertices, G can have no circuit. That implies G is connected as well as G is circuitless, which implies G is a tree. Theorem: a tree with n vertices has n minus 1 edges. The proof is done by the induction on the number of vertices. So it is easy to see that the theorem is true for n is equal to 1, 2 and 3. Assume that the theorem holds for all trees with fewer than n vertices. So now consider a tree with n vertices. In tree T, let EK be an edge with n vertices VI and VJ. So, according to a theorem, there is no other path between Vi and Vj except Ek. Therefore, the deletion of Ek from T will disconnect the graph. And furthermore, T minus Ek consists of exactly 2 components. And since there were no circuits in T, each of these components is a tree. So, both of these trees, T1 and T2, have fewer than n vertices each. And therefore, by induction, we can say that each consists of 1 less edge than the number of vertices in it. Thus, T minus Ek consists of n minus 2 edges. Hence, T has exactly n minus 1 edges. Hence, the proof. And next theorem, any connected graph with n vertices and n minus 1 edges is a tree. The proof is, a graph with n vertices and n or more edges will have circuits. And a connected graph will have at least n minus 1 vertices. Hence, G with n minus 1 edges is definitely a tree. Next theorem, a connected graph is said to be minimally connected if removal of any one edge from it disconnects the graph. The proof is, a minimally connected graph cannot have a circuit. Otherwise, we could remove one of the edges in the circuit and still leave the graph connected. So, we can say that a minimally connected graph is a tree because it is connected as well as it is circuitless. So, it becomes a tree. And conversely, if a connected graph is not minimally connected, we can say that there must exist an edge E in G such that G minus E is connected. Therefore, E should be in some circuit which implies that G is not a tree. So, it's a contradiction to the statement that if G is a connected graph which is minimally connected, it should be a tree. So, that's the next theorem. A graph is a tree if and only if it is minimally connected. Next theorem, a graph G with n vertices, n minus 1 edges and no circuits is connected. The proof is, suppose there is a circuitless graph G with n vertices and n minus 1 edges which is disconnected, and we will get a contradiction to the assumption. So, in that case, G will consist of two or more circuitless components, and without loss of generality, let G consist of two components, G1 and G2. Add an edge E between a vertex V1 in G1 and V2 in G2. Since there was no path between V1 and V2 in G, adding E did not create a circuit. Thus, G union E is a circuitless connected graph. That is a tree of n vertices and n edges, which is not possible because there is a theorem that is a tree having n vertices will be definitely having n minus 1 edges. So, this is a contradiction to the theorem. That means we have we get a contradiction. That means our assumption that there is a circuitless graph with n vertices and n minus 1 edges will be disconnected. So, that means a graph with n vertices, n minus 1 edges and circuitless will be connected. So, summarizing the above theorems, that we can derive some equivalent definitions of a tree. That is, a graph G with n vertices is called a tree if first one, G is connected and is circuitless, or G is connected and has n minus 1 edges, or G is circuitless and has n minus 1 edges, or if there is exactly one path between every pair of vertices, or if G is a minimally connected graph, all these implies that G is a tree. So, all trees have pendant vertices or leaves. The reason is that in a tree of n vertices has n minus 1 edges, hence 2 into n minus 1 degrees to be divided among n vertices. So, no vertex can be of 0 degree. So, we must have at least 2 vertices of degree 1 in a tree. So, this makes sense only if n is greater than 2. So, that's the next theorem. In any tree with 2 or more vertices, there are at least 2 pendant vertices. Next is the definition of distance and centers in a tree. Distance means it is the length of the shortest path between any two vertices, and eccentricity is the maximum distance between two vertices U and V, and radius means it is the minimum eccentricity, and diameter means it is the length of the longest path in a tree T. And a vertex with the minimum eccentricity in a graph G is called a center of G. So, the diameter equals the maximum of the vertex eccentricities. So, in a disconnected graph, the diameter and radius are infinite because distance between vertices in different components is infinite. We use the word diameter due to its use in geometry, where it is the greatest distance between two elements of a set. Definition of a metric. A function d of xy is said to be a metric if it satisfies the following conditions. First one is non-negativity, That is, d of xy should be greater than 0 and d of xy equal to 0 if and only if x equal to y. Second condition is symmetry, that is, d of xy should be equal to d of yx. Third one is triangle inequality, that is, d of xy is less than d of xz plus d of zy for any z. Next, the theorem is the distance between vertices of a connected graph is a metric. So we are given some examples where the eccentricities and center of the vertices of a tree you should mark from the figure. Theorem: every tree has either one or two centers, or the center of a tree is a vertex or an edge. We prove this by induction on the number of vertices in a tree T. Let n be the number of vertices in T, and the first step is let n less than 2. With at most 2 vertices, the center is the entire tree. Next step is let n greater than 2. Form T dash by deleting every pendant vertices of T. So, by a lemma, T dash is a tree. Since the internal vertices on paths between the leaves of T remain, T dash has at least one vertex. Every vertex at maximum distance in T from a vertex U belongs to V of T is a pendant vertex. Since all the pendant vertices have been removed and no path between two other vertices uses a leaf. So, edges in T dash U is equal to edges in T of U minus 1 for every U belongs to vertex set of T dash. Also, the eccentricity of a leaf in T is greater than the eccentricity of its neighbor in T. Hence, the vertices minimizing the edge set of T are the same as the vertices minimizing the edge set of T dash. So, we can show that T and T dash have the same center. So, by induction, the center of T dash is an edge or a vertex. Next, the definitions of rooted and binary tree. A tree in which one vertex is distinguished from all the others is called a rooted tree. So generally the term tree means trees without any root. So for emphasis, they are sometimes called free trees or non-rooted trees to differentiate them from the rooted kind. Next, the definition of binary tree. A binary tree is defined as a tree in which there is exactly one vertex of degree 2 and the remaining vertices are of degree 1 or 3. The given figure is an example of a 13 vertex with 4 level binary tree. Since a vertex of degree 2 is distinct from all other vertices, this vertex serves as a root. So, every binary tree is a rooted tree. So, we can discuss the two properties of binary trees in the following slide. The number of vertices in n in a binary tree is always odd. This is because there is exactly one vertex of even degree and the remaining n minus 1 vertices are of odd degrees. Since the number of vertices of odd degrees is even, we can say that n minus 1 is even. Hence, n is odd. That's the first property of binary tree. Now, second property of binary tree is let P be the number of pendant vertices in a binary tree T, then n minus P minus 1 is the number of vertices of degree 3. This is because the number of edges in T equals n minus 1. And we can find the value of P as total number of vertices is n, and number of pendant vertices is equal to P, and number of vertex with even degree equal to 1. So, number of vertices of degree 3 will be equal to n minus p minus 1. And using the fundamental theorem of graph theory, that is, sum of the degrees of the vertices is equal to twice the number of edges, we can find the value of the number of pendant vertices p, and which is equal to n plus 1 by 2. The maximum level L max of any vertex in a binary tree is called the height of the tree. And the minimum possible height of an n-vertex binary tree is log to the base 2 n plus 1 minus 1. And the minimum possible height of an n-vertex binary tree is n minus 1 by 2. Counting trees. A graph in which each vertex is assigned a unique name or label That is, two, no two vertices have the same label is called a labeled graph. The distinction between a labeled and an unlabeled graph is very important when we are counting the number of different graphs. The following well-known theorem for counting trees was first stated and proved by Cayley and is therefore known as Cayley's theorem. The theorem is, the number of labeled trees with n vertices where n is greater than or equal to 2 is n raised to n minus 2. Next is the definition of spanning trees. A tree T is said to be a spanning tree of a connected graph G if T is a subgraph of G and T contains all vertices of G. Spanning tree is also sometimes referred to as a skeleton or scaffolding of G. It is to be noted that a spanning tree is defined only for a connected graph because a tree is always connected, and in a disconnected graph of n vertices, we cannot find a connected subgraph with n vertices. So, a disconnected graph with k components has a spanning forest consisting of k spanning trees. Next theorem is, every connected graph has at least one spanning tree. Then, an edge in a spanning tree T is called a branch of T. An edge of G that is not in a given spanning tree T is called a chord. Next theorem is, with respect to any of its spanning trees, a connected graph of n vertices and e edges has n minus 1 tree branches and e minus n plus 1 chords. Next is a problem. A connected graph G is a tree if and only if adding an edge between any two vertices in G creates exactly one circuit. Then next problem is, a graph is a tree if and only if it is loopless and has exactly one spanning tree. This is the proof for the problem in the previous slide. A graph is a tree if and only if it is loopless and has exactly one spanning tree. The proof is, if G is a tree, then G is loopless since G is acyclic. Also, G is a spanning tree of G. If G contains another spanning tree, then G contains another edge not in G, which is impossible. Let G be loopless and have exactly one spanning tree T. If G has an edge E not in T, then T plus E contains exactly one cycle because T is a tree. Let F be another edge in this cycle, then T plus E minus F contains no cycle. Also, T plus E minus F is connected because deleting an edge of a cycle cannot disconnect a graph. Hence, T plus E minus F is a tree different from T. Since G contains no such tree, G cannot contain an edge not in T, and G is a tree T. Next problem is, every n vertex graph with m edges has at least m minus n plus 1 cycles. The proof is, let k be the number of components in such a graph G. Choosing a spanning tree from each component uses n minus k edges. So each of the remaining m minus n plus k edges completes a cycle with edges in the spanning forest. Each such cycle has one edge not in the forest, so these cycles are distinct. Since k is greater than 1, we have found at least m minus n plus 1 cycles. So next problem, you have to do it by yourself. Draw all trees of n labeled vertices for n is equal to 3 and 4. Draw all trees with unlabeled vertices for the same n. And next is a set of problems that you have to do by yourself. So try to do and try to find the answer. Thank you.